We are inherently fringe as humans. Each of us is unique. We have different truths for myself versus you, but we can celebrate those collectively in a group.
If we look at how we approach pain healthcare, everyone is treated relatively the same way. You go to the doctor, you get your tests done, you're offered a suggestion for maybe conservative care, maybe more imaging, but then you're always given a timeline for success. Why don't you come back in 6 to 8 weeks and see what happens? What about sleep? If you struggle with sleep and the idea that you're supposed to be sleeping for 8 hours, but you're only getting 6 or 7, man, that's stressful. Should I even be sleeping for that long? Maybe I have a different biological clock. Maybe I have a different cultural experience or the way that I was brought up that changes my rhythm, if you will. Mental health and the stigmatization that comes with seeking it, seeking care. Some of us feel ashamed to feel anxious, depressed, sad, like those are not real human emotions. So we need to start asking questions. Should we continue to treat people in an isolated care, or should we look outwardly toward medicine and ways of helping each other that have existed since the beginning of time? The ideas on this slide here have existed forever. But all too recently, they haven't been acknowledged or properly researched.
So what's interesting is they come in for pain, but we actually drive into these other things and start using cannabis for the use of their anxiety and their sleep. As we know, anxiety heightens pain, lack of sleep decreases healing, increases inflammation, and then leads to pain.
With respect to CBD, it has shown such a wide range of therapeutic potential. How is it doing this? It has a favorable safety profile, and this is a mystery that's far from being solved.
We want to have a discussion about what happens when you actually take these products.
We've been working really hard on developing a line of water-soluble cannabinoid products.
As this entire volume of product gets metabolized, your body has the availability to work on this almost instantaneously.
Mainstream isn't actually a thing. Nobody can be pointed to as an archetype of mainstream. We're all different heights, we're all different sizes, we're all different colors. Every single person is fringe.
I certainly would like to make unconventional something that's widely accepted in our profession. And if that made me fringe, then that was actually probably a good thing.